Students, I hope all of you are well. Today I am going to start with the topic constructions. So your exercise for 11.1 is not in your syllabus now. It is a deducted part. So I am going to start with the 11.2. So this is a construction, how to draw the tangents. Tangents to a circle using center of the circle. So first of all, I'm going to start with I'm taking one of your question. First question, that is a draw a circle of radius 6 cm from a point 10 cm away from the center. So first I'm going to draw a circle of radius 6 cm. So first I'm going to draw a circle of radius 6 cm. So first I am going to draw a circle . Then from a center I am taking a 10 cm away. A point which is 10 cm away from it. This is your center. Let this point be P. Now first of all, draw a perpendicular bisector of OP. This is the perpendicular bisector. Let it be M. Then, by taking M as center and OM as radius, draw a circle . This is a dotted circle which intersect the previous circle at point A and B. Join PA and PB. PA and PB. So PA and PB is the length of the tangents. So you can also find the length of these two tangents. This length is 8 cm. You can also verify by using the formula which you can also apply in chapter number 10. That is, this is a right angle. This is OP. OP square is equal to OA square plus PA square. You have to find the length of this PA. OP is, already you know the radius, it is 6 cm. OP is the length 10 cm and OA is the radius, it is 6 cm. So you can find here
It is a square root 64. So this is the verification of how the length of PA is 8 centimeter. Similarly, you can draw the other questions. This is your second question. Construct a tangent to a circle of radius 4 centimeter from a point on a concentric circles of radius 6 centimeter. So this is a circle. There are two concentric circles, one of radius 4 and the other is 6. All of you know the concentric circles which have a same center but the different radius. So first of all, I am taking here a circle of radius 4 centimeter. Then I am taking here of circle of radius 6 centimeter, the second concentric circles. So these are the two circles. Now we have to take any point on the outer circle, let it be P, and this is our center O. Now join OP . The method is very simple. Again, we have to draw from P to this the inner circle. Similarly, here from P to this circle, the method is join OP, then draw the perpendicular bisector and draw a circle. Same here, draw the perpendicular bisector of OP. This M is the midpoint of OP. By taking M as center and OM as radius, draw a circle which intersect the inner circle at point A and B. Join PA and PB. PA and PB are the required tangents. Measure the length. Also verify the by using actual. This is the actual calculation to verify it. So first of all, here we know that this is OP square is equal to OA square plus PA square. OP is length this one 6 and OA is the radius of the inner circle. So this is how it is 36 minus 16 PA square square root 20. So square root 20 actually it is 2 under root 5. The value of under root 5 is 2.236. So that is approximately 4.5 or 4.6 centimeter. 4.5, 4.4. So the actual length of this is here. So I have a 4.5. So either it is 4.4 or 4.5, it is correct. So you can solve it by actual calculation. So 4.4 or 4.5. Similarly, your next question. The next question is draw a circle of radius 3 cm. Take two points P and Q on one of the external diameter, each of distance 7 cm from the center. Draw a tangent to a circle from these two points P and Q. So first of all, draw a circle of radius 3 cm. So I am taking here 3 cm. Draw a circle of radius 3 cm. So this is the center of the circle. From here 7 cm both side. From both sides. So there are the two points P and Q here. On one side it is P and Q. Both sides it is 7 cm. Now we have to draw tangent from P and Q respectively. So first of all, the method is very simple. From where you have to draw the tangent, join it with the center, then draw a perpendicular bisector of that line segment. So I am going to draw a perpendicular bisector of OP first. Similarly here OQ. here. Let one point is M and other is N. By taking M as center, draw a circle. By taking PM as center or OM as center, it is one and the same thing. Same here. We are at intersect the regional circle. Let one point is AB and the other is CD. Join PA, PB. Same here. QC and QD. So here PA is equal to PB and QC is equal to QD. The next question is very simple, so I am going now, I am not using these instruments, mathematical instruments. So now I am going to draw simple figures here. The next question is, draw a pair of tangents to a circle of radius 5 cm which are inclined to each other and angle of 60 degree. So how will you draw? First of draw a circle of radius 5 cm This circle is of radius 5 cm. Then take any radius here. First, I am taking here point A. Now OA is a radius. At point O, draw an angle of 120 degrees. So why it is 120 degrees? I will tell you about it. So why it is 120 degrees? Let this be point B. Because we know that, so I am going first rough figure. So these are the two tangent. Let this be a 60 degree. Here it is given that the two angles or two tangents to a radius or to a circle are inclined at an angle of 60 degrees. So it is very clear that the central angle will be the supplementary angle. These two angles are supplementary. So that means this will be 120 degrees. So why I am taking here 120 degrees. Now at A, draw a right angle here again. To make a tangent here. Similarly at point B, draw a tangent which inclined an angle of 60 degrees. So draw a tangent, because tangent and radius are always making a right angle. Point of contact, at point of contact, tangent and a radius are perpendicular to each other, so that means draw a right angle here. Similarly, draw a right angle here. These both are PA and PB, inclined an angle of 60 degree. Because of this is 120 degree, the angle, these two angles are always supplementary. This is a cyclic quadrilateral, so are making supplementary angles. So that means it is a 60 degree. So if here angle is, suppose here they inclined an angle of 100 degree. So then what is the measure angle of here? 80 degree. Similarly, if here angle is 45 degree, suppose here it is 45 degree. 45 degree. Then the central major angle will be 135 degree. Similarly, if here the incline and angle of 30 degree, that means here angle will be 150 degree. So the other questions are same. Question number 5, question number 6. So you complete these two questions also. 5 and 6. If there is any problem, then you can message me or call me. Now you complete this exercise 11.2. Okay, students. Thank you.